Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to discuss linear inequalities in one variable. On the screen, you see three inequalities, and we're going to solve all of them. Let's go ahead and start with part A, which is minus 3x minus 2 is less than 4. Solution. So in this case, we want to start by trying to isolate the minus 3x term. So because we have a minus 2, we can simply add 2 to both sides, cancel, and so we get minus 3x is less than, and then 4 plus 2 is 6. And now we simply have to get rid of this minus 3. Because we're multiplying by a minus 3, we have to undo it by dividing. So we divide both sides by negative 3, these cancel, and when you divide by a negative number, you have to reverse the inequality. This ends up being x greater than negative 2. To write the answer in interval notation, you could do it in your head, or you could draw a little picture. Here's the real line, and then here's negative 2. And we're looking for all of the x's that are bigger than negative 2, so all the ones over here in white. But we're not including the negative 2, so we use a parentheses. If instead we had a greater than or equal to, then we would use a bracket. But because it's greater than, it's just a parentheses. And so the answer in this case is simply going to be from the picture, parentheses negative 2 to infinity. Good stuff. Let's do part B, solution. There is a formula you can use to do part B. It basically says if you have the absolute value of x less than a, where a is a positive number, so in all of this, a is positive, then you can drop the absolute value and then you just get less than a greater than negative a. So here we can drop the absolute value and so we get x plus 1 less than 2 greater than negative 2. I'm reading it backwards when I say greater than negative 2. So one way to memorize it is whenever you have a less than, you just put a less than and a less than, and then you keep this one and then you flip the sign. Okay, so less than, less than, less than, less than, less than, less than. Now we can solve this pretty easily. You simply subtract 1 from all three sides. So minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. We get negative 3 is less than x. Is less than 2 minus 1 is 1. These are all the numbers between negative 3 and 1. So if you wanted to graph these on a number line, we would plot negative 3 here, we'd plot 1 here, and it would be everything in between. And again, because we don't have an equal to in the inequalities, we just have less than's, it's parentheses. So the answer here would be negative 3 to 1. Good stuff. Finally, we have part C. Let's go ahead and work out that piece. Solution. So there is a formula we can use for part C. It basically says if you have the absolute value of x bigger than a, this means that x is bigger than a or less than negative a. So in this case, we can't quite use the formula yet because technically we're supposed to solve for the absolute value. Let's start by dividing by the 2 so it fits the form of the formula. So dividing by 2, we have the absolute value of x plus 5, and that's bigger than 3. And now we can apply the formula. So this whole thing here is our x. So we have x plus 5 bigger than 3, or x plus 5 less than negative 3. Just using the formula, right? You drop the absolute value, you put a greater than, you keep the number, and then you flip it, flip the inequality, and put a negative sign. These are pretty easy to solve. We subtract 5 from both sides. So we get x bigger than negative 2, or, again, subtract 5 from both sides. We get x less than negative 8. Now we can draw a number line. And in this particular case, the number line is really, really helpful because it's not as easy. There's a better number line. Here's negative 2. And then negative 8 is going to be way over here. So initially I thought, let me fix that. Initially I thought, oh, negative 2 is smaller than negative 8. No, that's not the case. Negative 8 is smaller, right? So here's negative 8. Here's negative 2, right? 0 is over here. And so we want all the numbers that are bigger than negative 2, so over here. Or all the numbers that are less than negative 8, so over here. And we don't have equal to's in the inequalities. We just have regular inequalities with no equality, so it's parentheses. So from the picture, we can get the answer. It'll be negative infinity, negative 8, union negative 2 to infinity. Good stuff. And again, if you had something like, let's just say instead it was x greater than or equal to negative 2 or x less than or equal to negative 8, it would be exactly the same, except you would have negative infinity to negative 8 bracket, right, because of the equal to union bracket negative 2 to infinity, right? You would have the same thing you have here, except with brackets if you allowed for equality. That's a lot of examples, so hopefully you learned some mathematics. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Until next time, good luck.